This morning, a controversial cash-for-vapes scheme has been exposed. Leaked documents revealing big tobacco companies are paying pharmacists $275 to sell their vaping products, among other controversial payments.
Joining us now is the head of QUIT, Dr. Sarah White. Doctor, good morning to you and thanks for your time. What are your thoughts on these supposed kickbacks?
I just think it's absolutely disgraceful. I mean, we're supposed to be able to trust our community pharmacists that they're providing healthcare that's based on a patient's needs, not on some sort of secret deal from tobacco companies.
The Pharmacy Guild of Australia said they were unaware of this program, so therefore I guess it should be stopped if they're going to say it should stop.
Oh, absolutely. I think we see the Pharmacy Guild, the Pharmaceutical Society of Australia, which is the professional peak. We've seen the Royal Australian College of GPs, the Australian Medical Association. Everybody is coming out and condemning this. Perhaps we actually need to get some more legislative cover to stop this sort of thing happening again.
Vapes, as we know, are often lauded as a solution to kicking the habit of cigarettes. What are your thoughts on that? And you know, what is your advice to people who are wanting to quit cigarettes?
The information or the clinical trial evidence for e-cigarettes and their effectiveness in cessation is actually very limited. People really need to be using something like the QUIT line combined with products that are already approved by the TGA. So things like nicotine patches and gum and lozenges, using those together, that's really the best way for people to have a go at quitting smoking.
It's also running rampant, as we've been reporting here, in schools. Even though it's illegal to sell to under 18s, it's even hitting primary schools now. Do you think the message of how dangerous this is getting through to parents and kids?
It certainly hasn't been, David. I think we do need to do more there. We certainly need those enforcement efforts stepped up both at the federal level and at state and territory government levels where we get that enforcement of retail sales, just those illicit sales just stopped. Mm. We do also need our parents and teachers to be very aware that kids are getting their hands on these products. And companies like Philip Morris, who are trying to push e-cigarettes into pharmacies, they're also targeting kids on social media. So we absolutely need to get more understanding of the risks of addiction and the health harms of using e-cigarettes out there.
Okay. Dr. Sarah White, we appreciate your time this morning. Thanks for joining us.